to Wolf Farms. Come on down. I'm Don, also known as Knitting Wolf.
And I'm James, also known as Wolf Photo. This podcast is brought to you by Wolf Farms. You can find us on the internet at wolffarms.net. We have a scent of the month every month, as you know, and for the month of October, we are doing pumpkin spice. So you can get 25% off everything that's scented and the pumpkin spice like, fragrance through the month of October.
It's one of my favorites.
Yeah, I know. Don's, I make extra just so that we have a supply for the house.
Yeah, I need a new candle. I had burned mine all gone.
Yeah, I gotta get some more pumpkin
spice
candles.
But I did grab our fudge brownie. And I have it in the hallway bathroom. And it like permeates down the hall. And you just walk. You just want to lick this candle. I mean, fudge. I mean, it's just dripping. You want to, and it's the brown,
yeah,
dark.
Yeah, it looks like you could almost really look like fudge, but it's not.
Dip a strawberry in it, or.
But, yeah, that's a good one. But, you know, last week we talked about the chocolate beast. Well, yeah. This isn't helping.
No, it's not. But
it's like,
so
don't
yummy.
Eat it. Ah.
Yeah, we used to have that in our soap, but we haven't done that in a while.
Yeah, no, it's been a while since we kind of.
That I did try. Doesn't taste like chocolate.
They may smell good, but don't eat them. This is not edible.
Yeah.
Except for our lip balm, of course. And speaking of lip balm? We've added a new lip balm to the shop. Something just in time for Thanksgiving? Halloween. I always do that. By the way, I always do that. Screw that up. But for Halloween, we've got
a trick or
a
treat?
Yeah, trick or treat, which is butterscotch. It's not focusing here. Where are you at? There we go. Yeah, butterscotch.
Well, I know the fat squirrel and crafty pancakes, they both really like the butterscotch candle.
Yeah.
And this, so yummy.
Yeah. Mm. So we got this to go along with our other butterscotch stuff, but better yet, in the sake of Halloween, we are going to give this to you for free, at least for this week. This coming week, Monday through Sunday, just like we do with all of our new lip balms we add to the shop, we're going to let you try it out for free. So all you have to do is put this in your cart, buy $10 or more of other products, and then use the coupon code TRYME during checkout. You'll get it for free, and you can try it out and see if you like it. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. Don tested and approved.
Yeah. Like
and so,
one.
Yeah, so this special will be a week only, so give it a try. I'm sure you'll enjoy it, and your lips will thank you for it.
Yep, and I've been packaging up soaps this week, and one I packaged up is our candy corn, which falls into the line of the Halloween theme, you know?
Yeah.
It's like,
it's our fall.
I grabbed one of these.
Our fall treats.
Our bathroom, you know, it's like soaps everywhere. And
yep, so lots of good stuff out there for you to try.
Yep.
So don't forget to check out the what we got and throw in a butterscotch lip balm in there. And you can try it out for free.
And so, by the way, welcome. Welcome to returning.
New and returning viewers.
Yeah, I always stumble on that.
Yeah. Thanks for joining us this week.
Yep. So and our segments include, I just cut you
off. Yeah, you sure did.
Farm happenings, in the coop, flown the coop, to market, in the arena, and roundup. It's a quickie.
Yep, that's what we always say.
That's what we say.
We'll see how.
And before I forget, I'm wearing my Ripple Rock shawl I made last year, and they're both Cakewalk yarns, and the purple was the sincerest colorway mm-hmm. that she did for our knit along. And then the orange is something podcaster addict or.
Mm. I don't remember.
I just went right out of my head. But yep. And I know it looks like a shrug, but I tie it behind my back So it ain't going nowhere.
We get pretty wild. We don't want it flying off
of you. Wild on the farm.
So yeah. Let's get this underway. Farm happenings. Why? You just stalled out.
Right? I know. I'm like, well, nothing happened.
No. Yeah. We always have this discussion. But, well, we were supposed to go and do a Fuji round of chemo this week.
Yeah.
And we'll just do a quick Fuji update. And
Fuji's our little chihuahua, if you're new, and she has lymphoma. She's done 7 treatments, and she will be having 25.
Total.
So
we're just kind of like one-third, little less than one-third of the way through her treatment, for the lymphoma. But we had taken her in, or you had taken her in this week to do the blood work, which we always do ahead of time to see how she's doing with her white cell count and a couple other things that they measure that gauges whether we can go on with the next treatment. And it came back and she was too low on her white blood cell and then
the neutrophil
counts. And so we have to delay it a week. So she didn't have a treatment. She's acting fine. So it's not like she's showing that there's any issue. It's just the counts are too low because if they do the next round, it'll drop those even lower. And they want to make sure that she's at a level where, you know, when they give her the next round, that it doesn't cause other issues. So we'll be probably going in. She's got to do another blood work. We'll see where that's at this coming week. And then most likely go down this Thursday to get her next treatment. So
it seems that these chemos are really lingering in her system longer than
because there's a combination of different medicines that she gets or drugs, and it seems like every one of them, for some reason on her, they're lasting longer in her system than what the average dog does. And that's why they kind of modify it as we go based on her reaction to the chemicals, the drugs and stuff. And we just kind of play it by ear. And it's part of the, course of going through this, is you want to make sure that it's for her benefit, that we're not causing other issues and that she's not, feeling ill, but right now she's in remission. So that's a good thing. This is all stuff to kind of make sure that stays that way as long as possible. So that's, I think that was,
That's about it on that one. Yeah. So we'll see
how
it goes this week. It's day by day and week by week, so.
Yeah. And then one other thing that happened this week, kind of sad. Last week we showed you the new baby chicks that we had gotten. We had gotten 6 baby chicks, and we lost one on
Wednesday,
and then another one on Thursday. And so I'm not sure what happened.
The one on Thursday didn't have an eyeball, and then the other one wasn't really there.
She reminded me a lot of our turkey, which is blind.
Yeah.
Helen. Yeah, she had issues, and I was concerned about her. I would have, if we were going to lose one, I was expecting that. But it's actually one of our Reds that didn't make it on Wednesday. And I don't know what happened with that one. The other one, Helen, with the missing eye and everything, I was concerned that once we put her in with the other chickens that they'd attack her. Just because they first sense that when you have something wrong, they kind of jump on that. So we lost 2 of the 6, so we're down to 4, and they're growing. I thought I would, we'll give you an update picture next week on how big they're growing, but
Fuji keeps checking on them.
Yeah, it's funny. If I'm walking down the hall, she'll come alongside me. She'll hop in there, come back out, and whine. You got to show me. Got to check on the baby. So it's funny. She enjoys that.
Yep. So that's about it on the farm.
Yeah, it was one of those weeks that flew right by, and it seemed like we were busy.
And
we got the Wolf's Farm stuff happening, but that's that's always ongoing. We just get busy now this time of year, so it seems to fill up most of our free spare time. So.
Yep. So.
So.
I'm like, where's our next segment? In the coop.
In the coop.
Oh. I only have one thing in the coop this week, and this is in my Kikiboo bag. Denise, she just had her big birthday and party this weekend, so happy birthday, Denise. I can't wait to see the Instagram photos.
Well, you've been enjoying the Instagram photos from Rhinebeck.
Oh my gosh. It's like I'm there. You know, Minerva Turkey, Shannon, it's like... She posted the cute. If you're not following her, you need to, because she's been posting the cutest photos and Suburban Stitcher and Vintage Rose and the trees there.
Yeah.
It's just breathtaking. We don't get that.
I was
going
to say,
and it's like,
where we're at, trees, you have to work really hard to get a tree to grow. It's not like we're up in Washington where there's just. Oh, you know, they got trees all over.
Well, that amazes me, too, seeing the green.
Yeah.
Green.
We're in the desert. You know, our trees are, they look like large cactuses. You know, the natural ones out here. And they're far and few between. And they don't make much shade. But, you know, so when you get into an environment that's like, it's different world, kind of. But, yeah, awesome. They get the seasons back there. Yeah. We just go from, here we go from hot to cold. And, you know, at least there they kind of might, you know, it changes.
Yeah, so one year I want to go, because I have family there too. My dad was born there, and so we got a lot of family there, and so.
Yeah, we'll make that trip one of these days and head over and.
I want to see them, well, of course I want to see the yarn, and I want to get maple cotton candy. But yeah, you know, I've seen people post the apple cider donuts, and I'm like, oh. But yeah, and it's.
Carbs.
I know.
That's why you go on vacation, so you can have those things.
Yeah, I just want to bite one. So, back.
to In the Coop. Sorry, I sidetracked you there.
Yeah. So, I'm doing the Herbaceous Socks. I guess I could show the pattern first. And that's by Emily. She's at Rhinebeck right now, too. She had a birthday this weekend, too, but I will get to that. Herbaceous. Chain of Fools of the Fibertown podcast, and that's a $3 pattern on Ravelry. Guess I could click that and make it bigger, but and I'm using Fiber Files Super Squish Sock. I really don't think she's dying in the Sakura colorway, and I did. I'm trying to get it to where it'll show my
Dickie
Doo. Yeah. Okay. I did from my Dickie Doo to here, and then I did I'm just doing a normal heel flap, and then she has an option to do a heel flap on the bottom of your foot, but I was doing it last night, and I was
tired,
and I just automatically started doing a normal gusset heel flap thingy. But I'm like, I don't think I would like that on the bottom of my foot anyway.
Yeah, that would
so
bug
I'm
you.
I'm glad I kind of screwed up, but yeah, because I'm kind of like the princess and the pea.
Yeah, you could have a little pea under 10 mattresses and she would still feel it.
Yeah, my sheets have to be straight.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
So yeah, that would probably bug you.
Yeah, so I'm like. You know, I mean, I ended up putting it down, so I almost got the heel completely done, and I'm doing the pattern up the top. What's that, the instep?
Across the top there.
Yeah, so, and these are my Vintage Rose markers, the Chihuahua ones, which I just absolutely love.
Didn't she have an option to actually run the pattern on the base of the heel?
Yeah, she had where you could do this, correct. Yeah, where you could continue the pattern up. But I thought, nah, that ain't gonna really show.
Hmm. And maybe that's why she did the guest the way she did.
No, it's her new.
No.
It's a Emily foot thingy.
Oh.
You know, I was gonna try it, but then I just
you were tired
and
in an autopilot last night.
So this is still sock one. I don't know if you guys can hear the babies chirping. I forget that, because I'm so used to all the sounds that go on around here that I don't pay any attention. So.
You get immune to it after a while.
Yeah.
So that's it, huh? Yes. Well, I've got something in my coop.
Just leave it.
Sorry. I'll make my loop out there a little bit. I had finished up my long-awaited Hitchhiker last week, showed that off. And so I figured I'll start something simple to get going. And I started another pet blanket.
That looks much better.
Snuggle and stuff. And I actually had to tear this out because I chained, actually more than I probably should have because I don't think I have enough yarn to finish it. But I went chaining along and then started back. And I had chained really tight for some reason.
Yeah, like a guillotine.
I don't do this enough. So last night after I got, the row on and I thought, man, it's going to end up puckering that one edge. And I thought, I got to redo it. So this morning, ripped the whole thing out, started back over. So I did a couple rows this morning just to kind of get something so I could say I got something in the coop. And then Dawn is going to help me get a...
I'm like, what am I doing?
You're going to help me get... Because this is easy. I'll actually knock that out pretty quick. But we've been talking about doing a pair of socks. But I need her to sit down, while we're not relaxing at night, watching TV, sometime where I can actually pay attention and see what it is that I'm actually doing.
Yeah, and that's why I don't have stripy socks on the needles right now, although I got a lot of yarn wound up for it. I need more needles. So I can have more socks.
So but, you're waiting to I'm start waiting those to start. So I could get mine going at the same time so that I can kind of follow along and pick it up. So.
And Thumperina, she had a great idea to start you off with like worsted weight or sport weight, and kind of make just house socks. But I thought you would never, ever wear them. And then, two, I kind of pushed you with the...
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It'll take as long as it's going to take, as you found out with the hitchhiker.
Yeah.
So, I thought it'll be interesting, because I think the hard part, the hard part's doing the toe first, and then you just round, and then you get to the heel, and that'll be the next challenging part. But I need to get started one spot or the other, depending on if I'm doing toe up or top down, or
you're
I don't
gonna
know.
Do toe up.
Okay, well, that's what I figured. And
it's interesting. I was telling him this yesterday that, most people generally revert back to how they learn to knit socks. And I learned to knit socks through Kat Bordy's book, and it was, I can't remember which book, but it's where you use two circular needles cuff down, and I've never done it that way since. That was a horrible
thing. You cured yourself right out of the gate, huh?
Yeah.
You're improving it as you go.
I mean, I still wear those socks. I mean, they've lasted, a long time now? 8 years? 9 years? I don't know. And time flies. But, I've been really preferring the toe up.
Yeah.
Circular,
And you've been modifying the way you like, when you find a better method for doing things, you kind of incorporate that into the next round of socks, like your toes. You like the
Lauren toes.
Yeah.
And then usually I only like double points, and I've even gotten away from that.
Yeah. Well, so I'll figure out whether I'm going to stick with this. See, she's already done all the trial and error and figured out what works best, so I'll just take advantage of that. I'll start off right from the get-go. So I'll probably have those on the needles and hopefully working through that to show next week. But like I said, I wanted to get another snuggle or whatever we want to call them, pet blanket for the shelter going. And, I'll probably have this all wrapped up by next week.
You have more than one project.
See, I have so much time. And if I have two projects, I have the dilemma of which one to actually work on. But this one, like I said, with the crocheting, I could actually do it pretty quick. I'm getting, because it's been, I did one here not too long ago, so the technique is fresh in my mind. I can just kind of go along and, it's kind of a no thought. You just, and it's quick, a lot quicker than knitting, so.
Yeah, well, we're on season 3 of Breaking Bad. It's gotten better.
Yeah. We've been enjoying that.
Yeah.
Quite interesting. So we got to make it all the way through to, I think Netflix has either 5 or 6 seasons. So we got to work our way through that and then wait for the last season. So.
Yeah.
But that's what we do at night. So I can do this and still watch. Because if I'm trying to read a pattern in it, and it draws my attention away. So.
So flown the coop.
Mm.
Yeah, 2 flown the coop. The first one is my rainbow explosion socks. And this is the second one. And I went from, there's the dicky-doo, all the way up. Did the heel. Voila, 2. And this is Lauren McMorty. Limnet Crochet's pattern, another awesome pattern of hers, and this is mustache yarn.
mustache yarn.
It's the rainbowy. It is so. Look at that pattern. It is so pretty. Oh, you can't even see the. There's the little rainbowy. It is so pretty and so fun, and I love that like twisted rib. Cuff.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah. And they're so soft. So, another pair of socks in October. And then I finished my sockhead hat. I couldn't think of the name of it. So, from the Dicky Doo there all the way up, I got that finished up. This is big. I did the full 9-inch, you know, the 4-inch ribbing and then 9 inches here. Might have been a wee bit over because I just keep going round and round. And then the decreasing. So, yeah. And Fuji was my model. Yeah, Looney Hiker said, oh, that's her chemo hat. I think she could fit in this.
Yeah, I think you can actually just throw her in there. But I know how much she loves knitted stuff. She just hates it, and I could tell from the picture that John posted.
And I took like 10, 15 pictures.
I could
and
see,
she kept moving.
Yeah, I could see Fuji's face. I'm like, okay. She's thinking, don't bring up the sweaters. Don't bring up the sweaters.
I have a whole drawer in my dresser full of sweaters that I've knit for her.
And she does not like it.
You even go near that drawer, and she runs for the heels.
She's not a high society dog. She's a farm dog, and she says she doesn't want to wear that fancy stuff.
This is Dancing Dog Dye Works in the I Chihuahua colorway, too. So, yeah, that was a fun knit, and now I can wear it outside and
keep your head warm.
Yeah.
Now that it's getting cool.
Yeah, it's cool in the morning.
Yeah. 30s, yeah. So we're hitting fall.
Let's gotta wait till my acorn squashes get bigger when I can.
Our garden is still going. I'm worried that we're going to get that freeze, and then it's gonna,
because I have honeydews, I have zucchini still coming, acorn squash, butternut squash.
Yeah, we did a second round of planting, and it's coming in, and we've been getting zucchini and stuff off of it. It's been growing well, but the other stuff hasn't gotten to the point where we can actually pick it yet. So hopefully we get a little warm spell there, and I think we will, just to keep it above freezing.
It's still high 80s, 90s during the day, so.
It does that in the fall and the spring. We get these really wide swings, but I'm hoping we don't dip below and have it freeze, because then that's it for the garden for the year. So we'll see. That's hopefully that hangs on.
Yep.
So. I guess that's...
That was my flown the coop.
That was the flown the coop.
So, 2 market.
2 market. Okay, well, I have to chuckle about this one. So, a while back on some of the episodes, we had talked about a friend of mine at work had done home brewing, you know, and they'd given us some home brewed beer, the strawberry beer, and some apple cider and stuff. And we had kind of contemplated doing this home brewing stuff. And I even got a book from them, you know, that kind of goes through, how to brew. And so I had that for a while. And, it was a big book. And I thought, we're so busy. We'll never have time. So I actually gave it back to them last week. So that's kind of the preface to this. Well, you know, I go to garage sales. That's my thing on Saturdays. Me and Don's dad, we kind of cruise around and just, you know, it's kind of fun. You never know what you're going to find. Well, this weekend... I happened on a little treasure trove of home brewing equipment. And so, amazing deal. I've gotten basically it's a home brewing kit, an entire kit that was bought and never used by the person that I was getting this from. So, I mean, it came with like brewing, you know, the beginning kits, you do it in plastic buckets. You know, the more advanced ones get the glass, the big glass carboys that are used for brewing because they don't hold flavors and stuff like the plastic will. But I mean, it had two of these big brewing 6-gallon buckets and the spigots, and it had little different devices that are used to tell whether it's still fermenting, and then you can tell on how much alcohol you have. Came with a couple cases.
I thought that was for sugar.
Well, it is, and that's based on, that's how you calculate how much alcohol's in it. Hmm. Came with a couple cases of bottles. Came with a full-on benchtop bottle capper. I'm like, wow, you know.
And caps.
Caps, and it came with some brewing yeast and hops, but it was, I tossed it because I don't know how old this was. You never know, Agresso. So I bought it basically for the equipment, and it came with a book, came with instructions, came with the works. $5. Like, how can I go wrong with that? So now I got to go back to work and ask them to bring the book back so I can start reading up. Because, you know, it's got a little brewing book here. And actually, I want to start with, you know, so now that I've got all the equipment, may as well start doing some brewing. So so we were looking online. There's a lot of information there. But we're talking about, like, doing an apple cider type thing. And there's some really tasty sounding recipes. But, yeah, I'll dabble in it and see what happens, you know. But, yeah, I was... Of all the timing, like I said, I just returned the book last week and, you know, and here come across the, you know, perfect deal on everything you need to kind of get started. So I was kind of, it's kind of sidetracked me all weekend. Now I've got the gears turning on what we're going to do first.
Yeah.
But I mean, now it's got the super hooch bottles. I mean, this is 22-ounce bottle. So I was laughing about just the size of the bottle, but...
Guess what? Everybody's getting for Christmas.
Apple cider for everyone. Let me do a pumpkin cider instead.
Ooh.
Yeah, I know. See, this is what we've been doing ever since I came home with this. And I'm like, look what I got. New toys. But, I mean, like I said, the price was right, and how can you say no to that? So. So.
Fun stuff.
Yeah, the things I come across... You never know. It's always an adventure. That's what makes it fun.
Yep.
It's not like going to Walmart. You know what you're looking for. It's kind of you start with a blank slate every Saturday and see all the stuff that you can't live without.
So
that was my to market.
Yep. My to market this week. Emily Estrada from Fibertown Designs, Fibertown Podcast, Chain of Fools. She has a new pattern called Collie Wobbles. Right there, the name got me. But I don't care what this pattern looks like. Collie Wobbles, how fun is that to say? Well, she released this for her birthday this weekend. And so she has a coupon code and you can go get it off her podcast. And so it was free. And I'm like, how perfect. Look at that. You can do it with stripy yarn. You can do it with variegated. I mean, it's... You can say collie wobbles. I just love it. I mean, that is such a neat pattern.
Hmm.
So, I can't see this. More needles. So, that's going to be a fun one. And she's got her funky heel. See? You can see it there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that would bug me, I think, on my foot.
Yeah.
I think she said you don't feel it, though, but...
Hmm. Well, you have to do it once just to see what it's like.
But if my stitches on my hand-knit socks aren't really tight, ooh, I can feel those little lines.
Princess and the Pea over here.
So that was free, which I, you know. And then I got... where did it go?
It's hiding from you.
Yes, it is. Well, I went and got, because I keep hearing everybody talk about this Fish Lips Kiss Heal by Socks Therapist. And the whole, it's a whole ebook, and it's cuff down, toe up, and this is no wraps, no gaps, no mats, no flaps, no gussets. And I mean, that's, what a cool, and it's a dollar for this whole pattern. So I thought, since I've been doing all these socks, I want to, trying to bring up the picture. I want to try different heels. Although I could have done that on these last socks, and I ended up doing just a normal cassette heel. But yeah, it's a whole pattern, and you know, or you can just skip to the heel, or so that's going to be really cool. Hmm. And I thought, a dollar for all of this, you know? And she has newborn sizes in this, and adult, doll size, child. So, and she has video links. Oh, that's good. So, lots of information on here, and everybody who I've heard try it says it's really, really cool, so.
Hmm. More socks?
More socks. Even more socks, once I find where it went. Megan Williams of the Stockinette Zombies, she had a thing where if you have any of her patterns, you can get her OMG heel socks, you know, just how to do the heel for free. So I went over and grabbed that because I thought, oh, a whole other different kind of heel. So, yep. Thought that would be cool to try too, since I'm in this sock mode again. I haven't been in a sock mode like this since that was one of my first knittings. Because I have a whole drawer, and you know, I got to the point of, you know, I have all these, and they still are all fine.
Yeah.
You know.
You did Instagram a picture, I think, of your sock drawer here not too long ago.
I guess I need to work on a new sock drawer. You only have one sock.
One sock.
One sock.
I want to go in circles.
Call you Dobby. You only need one sock. Yeah. You're free.
I'll stick it in my book.
Yeah. So, yep, that was Two Market.
All right.
So in the arena, I wanted to mention for our Hatch and Knit and our Fight Like a Girl thread, Courtney of So For You is going to be donating a bag, and she's been updating her shop with lots of good stuff, and she just went and bought some more fabric, so be expecting some new things. She's got zipper pouches. That was their new thing this week. Long zipper pouches, normal 6x5 zipper pouches, perfect for notions, and so she's just adding stuff all the time. Then we have our soccer along. Really? Soccer along? And that's soccer, the ER is because we've been doing it September, October, November, and December. And we do prizes every month. So the more socks you do, you know.
Enter them in and you can win some good prizes.
There's two bags donated from Bird Leg Bags, two codes for yarn from Fish Knits. We have other donated yarn, and so lots of prizes for that. And
the quicker you get them in, the more opportunity you have to win as we go along, because we'll keep drawing from the pool of entries.
Yeah, and I forgot to mention my pink socks are for Knit Nerd and Knitting Den's Pinktober. Hmm. So, plus Fiber Town's Herbaceous Along. So,
excellent.
So, round up,
huh? I guess that is
me. Told you it's going to be quick.
Wanted to mention that we still have the Fuji Fight Like a Girl buttons in the shop, that you can buy those and help out with the Fuji treatment costs. We also have our Wolf Farm video podcast button you can have for free. Just with any paid order, you can add that in the comments when you're checking out. You know, just go through that, and then as you're doing the checkout, put in the comment section that you would like a video podcast button, and we'll be happy to throw one of those in your package as we're shipping that out. And you can decorate your knitting bag or your button monster or wherever you want to put it to decorate. You just, you know, we'll throw one in there for you so you can enjoy that. Don't forget, we have our new in the shop butterscotch lip balm. You can try that out for free as well. Kind of our Halloween treat bag for you. You just order $10 or more of other items. Add this into your cart so your total will actually be like $12.95. And then you put in the coupon code TRYME and it will deduct out the $2.95 that for that product. So that way you'll get it for free. You can try it out. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. I mean, it's the perfect time with the, all the candies. No calories, no teeth issues. So, and your dog might like it too. I know there's some people that who have dogs that enjoy our lip balm as well. So don't forget about that. I think that's about it. So,
so until next time,
let's get cracking
and
hatching it. Bye, y'all.